Ed here with the Digital Digest, and today I wanted to share a quick unboxing and first look at the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 3. This 5G handset will officially be available tomorrow, August 27th, 2021, and what it brings to the table at a less expensive price than the first or second gen is pretty impressive. We have improvements, I would say, all around. The device hasn't changed that much, but we now have S Pen support. It doesn't come with the phone, sadly, neither does an actual wall charger, something I'll get to a little bit later. We also have IPX8 rating now, which means water resistance, something I know a lot of you were waiting for, myself included. Even though it didn't prevent me from taking my Z Fold 2 pretty much everywhere, it wasn't going to be anywhere near water. I did use it in the rain. Of course, it's a phone, you still need to, but this will, of course, bridge that gap and make it a thing of the past in terms of general concerns. Now, at $1,799, I think this is definitely a more aggressive offering. We have 256 gig internal storage as well as 512. I went with the 512 because to me, the whole beauty of this device is having essentially a computer in your pocket, and that's what the 512 gig version, in my opinion, represents, especially since we do not have any way to expand storage. Now, before I unwrap this beauty, let's see what else we have in the box, which isn't a lot. SIM ejector key actually already fell out, the tool, and this is an unlocked version for those of you that are wondering. Beyond that, I do think that Samsung should have included a charger with this, but their reason why they omitted it was, well, the Apple reason for the environment. And I'm all for that. However, you know, I'm not really so sure that that was the difference, considering, I mean, part of the argument is that this only supports 25 watt quick charging. There, of course, is that Type-C Type-C cable for charging. But their assumption is that most of us already have a brick. And in all likelihood, you probably do if you've bought a phone in the last 2 years. Now, we have a matte black finish here, which I'm happy about. Hopefully it makes the phone a little bit less slippery. One of the key improvements, though, is that we now have, beyond that, 120 hertz on the front display, which you're about to see. A refresh rate that was reserved only for the 7.6 inch internal display in the past. And in addition to that, you know, the ability to use an S Pen with this, I think, really bridges the gap for any users that, like myself, were Note users historically. And then when this phone launched, the original Fold and then second gen, we had all hoped that Samsung was going to give us an S Pen before we even knew that the Note may be on the chopping block and discontinued, because after all, this is Samsung's most powerful and dynamic device. Now, this is a little bit lighter than the previous generation. Again, I've been using the Z Fold 2 since launch, and I can already tell it's a little bit more compact. The front display is a little bit more, well, I should say they shrunk the bezels a little bit. Still tall and narrow. We have a 10 megapixel selfie camera on the top center, and then we have three 12 megapixel cameras on the back, wide angle, telephoto, and traditional fixed prime. And then on the internal, you can see the cutout right now for the under camera display, and that is a 4 megapixel camera. And to my knowledge, this is the first phone to incorporate that. Another thing I will tell you right now is that this screen protector that they're using on the internal display is supposed to be superior to the previous gen, which I'm hoping that it is as I press the power button now. Hopefully we have enough charge to boot, and we do. And I say that because the previous generation got dirty very quickly. It had a very sticky feeling to it. I didn't really care, but I can't tell you the number, well, maybe you already know, the number of people that complained about this. So this does feel a little bit different, no question. I'll see over time if it actually holds up to not getting too dirty and looking gross. I have to say that was one of my own personal pet peeves with the previous gen. In terms of having, I can already tell you the fold, the actual hinge, does feel tighter. And now you can see the underscreen camera, which I can clearly still see the cutout. It has pixels that are lit, obviously, in front of it so that it tries to blend in with the display. Now, I think on camera, it does a better job of blending in than it does in person. But I may be wrong. I have to see and get used to it. I'm not sure whether I like this more or not. The fact that we downgraded from a 10 megapixel to a 4 megapixel does kind of leave me with the impression that I will always be using this front-facing selfie camera. Is that a good thing? I don't know. But One thing is certain, with the new IPX8 rating, as well as S Pen input, we still have a fingerprint scanner, of course. That is also your power button. We also have, of course, the volume rocker. You can see the bay right there for your SIM card. If you have 5G in your market, which I do not, of course, 5G will work. This is still a really nice phone, and I love that we went matte here. It's, you know, not going to be incredibly grippy, but still better, I think, than the previous generation. There was something about the all-glass finish that left something to be desired. And, you know, my Z Fold 2, I'm not going to get rid of it. It's just going to go to a family member. I did enjoy using this case, the kickstand case, carbon fiber on it, but I always left it nude, so to speak. And that's because it just got too bulky with pretty much any case on it. So we'll see over time, you know, how these things fare, but you can already see that they're incredibly similar. Most people will say that the phones are basically identical, excuse the case, but in spite of all of that, just the things I've mentioned, again, S Pen input, the fact that we have a Snapdragon 888 or 888 under the hood, which is definitely an upgrade in overall processor performance. We have the same amount of RAM, 12 gigs of RAM, but I think that the entire sum of its parts is quite impressive, but the S Pen and water resistance are really what makes this generation unique. So whether or not that's enough for you to take the plunge, the fact that the price went down isn't bad, and I've already mentioned I love the fact that we've got a higher storage capacity, since of course it cannot be expanded. But it's a really nice device. If you didn't like the first or second generation in terms of its form factor, you're not gonna like this one either. Let's be real. And people who complain about the thickness, well, folding phones, I feel like just aren't for you. If I had to have any critique here on day one of my unboxing, it would really be that I still have mixed feelings about the under-display camera. I think it's innovative. I think it's a wise choice, but I'm not sure that it's ready for prime time based on what I'm seeing right now. I didn't really need cover-up. I was fine with the cutout. In fact, I didn't think the chin was hideous on Gen 1 that cut into the display, but of course, that was because it was the first device of its kind. Now, after Gen 2, we expect to have a nice clean layout like this. I, for one, may actually prefer that we don't even have a camera there, believe it or not. What I do wish, beyond what we already have here, is that Samsung would go back, like Gen 1, and give us the best of the best when it comes to the cameras, rather than giving us a step below. Video is capped out at 4K 60 frames. I think we should be able to get 8K on a phone like this, considering they have 8K on inferior phones. But overall, you know, kudos to Samsung for just improving on something that people, I think, often think can't be improved. I made a lot of predictions ahead of this. Samsung didn't really live up to many of those except the S Pen and water resistance. Yes, the crease is still visible and you can still feel it, but I really think that's a marginal issue. Hopefully next gen, they look at what Lenovo did with the X1 Fold and they emulate it, because they don't have a crease. So, Sammy, you can do it too. But this definitely has a firmer feel. Build quality seems really good. The battery is slightly smaller, actually 100 milliamps less than the previous generation. But from everything I've seen, battery life is pretty much identical. So we'll see how it fares. But overall, I'm excited about this phone for good reason, and stay tuned for updates as well as my unboxing and first look at the case that includes the S Pen, because that's what this is all about. If this was going to be the top of Samsung's lineup, it had to incorporate the S Pen, and now it finally does. As for the rest, we'll see over time, but I'm excited to obviously have this in hand, and it's not just a new device, even though it looks very much the same. Again, some game-changing improvements, in my opinion. We still have a little bit of wobble when it's flat on the table from the camera hump, but an impressive device that I'm excited to start putting through its paces and share my experience with all of you. Any questions or comments, please feel free to post them. Hit that like button, and as usual, please feel free to subscribe, and please stay safe. Later.